Well, I guess nobody wants that to happen at their power station. I don't know if you've ever witnessed such a dramatic event as a rotor stator, but fortunately they don't happen very often. But when they do, they're quite spectacular and noisy.
In February 1999, after 4 years of construction, Salto Caxias hydroelectric plant, installed on Iguazu River, Brazil, is about to commission 4 units of 310 megawatts each, with the promise to provide electricity to 4 million people, roughly 40% of Paraná's population. At that time, no one suspected that a catastrophic failure could be imminent.
So they had 4 units at this power station, they were building them. And the OEM that won the bid had a new design. Well, at that time, it was a new design. And the design just simply was that the rotor rim, it was actually a shrink fit rim. But if the unit ever went beyond 110% speed, the rim would be allowed to move around, what we call floating around, to absorb the centrifugal forces.
The utility accepted the bid on the condition that the OEM would be able to validate or confirm the performance of the rotor rim to make sure it performed as designed. To do so, they installed 16 air gap sensors on all 4 units, 8 at the upper part and 8 at the bottom part, to look at the rotor and see how it behaves during overspeeds.
When I got there for this particular visit, they had done some initial testing. And that was prior to the commissioning. And in fact, we could see that some coaxial cables were already ripped off. They were actually clipped by the rotor. In reality, for the cables to be clipped, something needed to be at a distance less than 3 millimeters from the core, because the cables are very small. And to be able to rip a cable off, it needs to be at least 3 millimeters close to the stator. So in reality, in the end, they found some pole interconnections that were actually damaged. So they were very close to hitting the stator core.
That was the first indication there was a potential issue with the rotor. When they were ready to begin the commissioning, the utility wanted to do a controlled overspeed test to make sure the rotor performed correctly.
Overspeed condition is something that hydro generators can be expected to go through at any time. If they're producing power and for some reason they get disconnected from the grid, they'll go into overspeed, and the OEM has to show that the unit is able to survive this. So they did a controlled overspeed test, and at the same time they wanted to use the results to see if the rotor rim actually performed as the OEM had designed. It was quite fast. I think they went up to 154% speed, which is very fast for large units like this. And we took the readings during that test and we started to analyze the results. And if you looked at the graph, you could see that the air gap during the overspeed was much smaller than the design. The design was 19 millimeters and the results were around 14 millimeters. So the air gap during this test was much smaller, but that's to be expected. Again, the excessive centrifugal forces caused the rotor to increase in size, so therefore the air gap is smaller. And in addition, we could see that the rotor shape, the rotor circularity, was very high, was in fact beyond critical. And again, that's also to be expected because that's the design of the rotor. The rotor is moving, it's distorting to absorb the centrifugal forces, so you expect to see a shape that is distorted. And as they slow the unit down, you could see the air gap increase because the rotor is slowly shrinking in size. There's less and less centrifugal forces, so the rotor is decreasing in size. And also, it's moving less and less, so the rotor circularity, its rotor shape, was actually also improving.
If you look at the initial results, everything looked like the unit performed as designed. Everybody thought that the rotor rim was actually doing what it was supposed to.
Although it seemed to be doing what it was supposed to, it was in fact going back to a shrink fit. But the issue was that it was doing so at a speed that was way too slow.
These particular units were designed to allow the rotor rim to float. As the speed reached 110% of the nominal speed during an overspeed or a load rejection event. In this case, the nominal speed was 90 RPM, so 110% speed was 99 RPM.
But in fact, not only did it miss the 99 RPM target, it also missed the 90 RPM target, which is the nominal speed.
The rim went back to its original shape or position at 80 RPM. If the unit was operating at full load, there would be tremendous heat, tremendous electromagnetic forces produced by the rotor, and tremendous electromagnetic forces produced by the stator. With these results in mind, and at that operating condition, it isn't hard to imagine the rim starting to float. Obviously, that would have been catastrophic. The rotor rim would have been pulled off and the stator would have been destroyed. The results were analyzed and the OEM went back to the drawing board. They increased the constraints for the rotor rim. They wanted to make sure the rim would start to float at a higher speed, therefore avoiding that 90 RPM limit. The modifications were performed by the OEM and tests were conducted. Fortunately, the rotor performed flawlessly. If that problem had been left unchecked, the utility might have had four major rotor stator runs, causing tremendous amounts of damage. Vibro Systems Air Gap Monitoring System, commonly known as AGMS, helped the utility and the OEM solve these issues and prevent any damages. As testified by the customer, the repairs and verification using the AGMS saved significant time and costs. The new method should be adopted in the future since it detects problems before the commercial operation of the units. Test results comparison is made before and after corrective action, showing the AGMS ability to detect the problem and to confirm the repair effectiveness.
To me, that was a very good case of everybody working together to solve a problem. It was a very interesting case. It was a very eye-opening case because I could see how you can use the information from such a system and learn a great deal, be able to assess, analyze, and correct a problem very easily.